The first reading for the Vigil Mass of the Assumption of Mary into Heaven describes King David overseeing the Levitical priests carrying the Ark of God into Jerusalem. The Ark of God contained that which was most holy for the Israelites. It contained the Ten Commandments given to Moses, a jar of manna, the heavenly manna that fed the Israelites when they were wandering the deserts, and a jar of that, and Aaron's staff that had miraculously budded. Around 300 to 400 years later, in Jerusalem, the Babylonians came and conquered Jerusalem and conquered the kingdom of Judah, the southern kingdom of Judah, and deported its people. And during that time, the great prophet Jeremiah took that which was most holy to the Israelites, the ark and what was in the ark, and went to Mount Nebo, the same mountain that Moses stood on and watched the promised land before he died. There on Mount Nebo, Jeremiah hid the ark. Today's first reading, for not the Vigil Mass, but for the Sunday Mass, is from Revelation, not from Chronicles. It's from Revelation, specifically the end of chapter 11 and the beginning of chapter 12, and it relates directly to the first book of Chronicles. We will see how. So, chapter 11 ends with John seeing a vision of a heavenly temple, and it's opened. And what does he see inside the heavenly temple? The Ark of the Covenant. Remember that John knew that that Ark had been lost for hundreds of years because Jeremiah had hidden it on Mount Nebo, and now he sees the Ark inside the temple. This is followed immediately by chapter 12, which is, according to scripture commentators, is to be interpreted as a continuation of 11. And then 12 identifies the ark as what? As a woman. Chapter 12. Revelation. John sees a woman, and she is the ark. And this woman is clothed with the sun. The moon is under her feet. She's crowned with 12 stars, and she's pregnant. And there's a dragon, an evil dragon that is waiting when right at the moment when she gives birth, that dragon wants to eat her child or eat her son. She gives birth, she escapes from the dragon, she flees. According to ancient scripture commentary, Mary is the fulfillment of that woman, and Jesus is the fulfillment of the child of that woman. Mary is the new ark, the new covenant, since Mary bore something or someone much greater than the Ten Commandments written in stone, or the heavenly manna that fell from the sky and fed the Israelites, or the staff of Moses' brother Aaron that miraculously budded. Jesus is greater than the Ten Commandments since he is the law in person, in the flesh, as the way, the truth, and the life. We meet Jesus through the gospel reading where Mary, pregnant with Jesus, is traveling to her cousin Elizabeth of the house of Levi. Upon meeting Mary, Elizabeth cries out how blessed Mary is among women. Why does Elizabeth cry out by saying Mary is blessed among women? Because Mary is the fulfillment of the holy ark of the Old Testament that was carried into Jerusalem by the Levitical priests as King David watched and the people rejoiced. Today, may we rejoice that Mary, the Ark of the New Covenant, has been carried not into the earthly Jerusalem, but into the heavenly Jerusalem by being assumed by her Son into heaven. There with her Son, who is the fruit of her blessed womb, Mary in expectation waits for us one day, God willing, to join her not only with our souls, but also with resurrected, transformed, resurrected bodies. God bless.